Hi everyone, today I'm going to share the features in the top bar of Forscore. So when you're using the Forscore app for iOS, there is a bar at the top that says the title of the piece and then an arrow. If you click that arrow, it comes up with a bunch of different options. So today I'm going to show each one and what they all do. If you're new here, my name is Elizabeth and I run the blog lifefromtheviolasection.com where I share practice tips, general advice, and my favorite tech for musicians. Let's go see what all of those features are. Today we'll be looking at the top bar in Forscore. So if you tap on music, it's this top bar right here. When you just tap on it, it shows the title of the piece of music that you're working on. If you tap this button on the left, it enables half page turns. So when you tap the page, it shows the top half of the next page. Then tap again, it shows the rest of the page. Top half of the next page, then the full next page. And again, the opposite backwards. I personally don't use that, but I know a lot of people do and they really like it. If you choose this arrow on the right, it brings up a bunch of new options. The first option is the annotate feature. So, you know, just like always, this is just annotating. If you'd like to learn more about the annotation features, I do have a video all about the features and you can find that in the eye of this video. Next is the share button. Here you can share either the plain PDF, you can choose a page range, you can choose the annotated PDF, which is the PDF with all of your annotations on it. Again, you can choose a page range and you can choose different aspect ratios. The third option is a Forscore file. It exports and you can share it all of these different places, just like any other kind of iOS share feature. The third option is queue. Queue allows one Forscore user to navigate and have nearby devices follow along automatically. I wish I could show this to you, but I only have one device with Forscore, so I can't show you, but you can imagine if multiple people in an ensemble all have Forscore on their iPads, one person becomes the leader when they turn the pages, the other Forscore devices follow and turn the page. And you can either choose to follow the leader's page turns, you can follow program changes, which is going between different scores, follow both, and dual page mode means you can see two pages on the screen at once. The fourth option here with the little arrows in the circle puts you into performance mode. So you can see I can tap anywhere, nothing happens. I can draw with my pencil. It doesn't bring up the annotation feature. So this brings you directly into performance mode. It's just an easy way to get to that. To leave performance mode, just hit the X and you're out. And now the pencil works for annotating. Tapping on different spots brings up the different features. The next function we have here is record. So you see a little recording box popped up. Tap on the mic and you can see it's recording. You can make recordings, finish recording, you can name it, save it. And you can use this little hamburger menu to bring up your recordings. You can also delete them right from here or share them. And to close out of this menu, just click the X. Next, we have goals. It's this little circle with part of it grayed out. So here you can see kind of your stats. This shows how long you were in Forscore each day. You can share this information. So right now it's on the goals page. You can go over to analytics and see which pieces you looked at each day. Let's go over here. So I played a duo with my boyfriend. I played a piece by Maria Newman. I worked on some orchestral excerpts. That's everything, a lot of excerpts. And you can see exactly how long you were in each piece and the total amount of time. So that was 2 hours and 41 minutes that day. This little setting feature, you You can just change some settings, you can reset all the data, or you can disable the whole dashboard. Then we have reports. And this just kind of shows you a weekly analytic report. So you can create goals for yourself. You can create a goal of 1 hour. And you can choose a certain piece. So saying that I want to practice this piece for an hour every day, or like 2 hours a week or something like that. So this can be a really powerful feature. I haven't played around with it too much, but if you'd like more of an overview of it, I can definitely play around with it and show you all of the secrets of it. The next feature in this group is just a little setting icon, and you can pull up a few quick features right here, just display options. If you'd like the page to be more yellow or more blue, and if you'd like to have half page turns and that different just display options. Finally, we have a little three-dot menu, and this lets you rearrange the different settings in this tab. So I don't need queue. I would like record to be the first one, then perform, then goals. So now mine is rearranged, but I waited to do that until I showed you all the features in the original order, just so it's a little easier for you to understand if you're new to this. So those are all of the functions in the top bar of Forscore. If you have any questions about the features that I shared today, please leave them in the comments. And if you have anything you'd like to see in depth in regards to Forscore, please just let me know and I'll make a video on it. If you enjoyed this video today, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I post new videos every Sunday at noon Eastern Time. Thanks for watching.